Well, hello there. Welcome to my Sims 4. This is going to be the usual playthrough like everybody else is doing, but maybe I'll do things different, which I probably will. But I like to just go with the flow, just go with whatever happens and just let the guy do whatever he wants. And talking of the guy, here's my guy, Flabadah Biddleplot. And I really couldn't think of a name. I'm like, it's loosely based on me. I mean, I kind of picked the nerd brain, quick learner, genius, geek, and outgoing. That's kind of like, yeah, like you probably saw in my creator sim demo play thing or whatever. And so, yeah, I mean, he's got a bit of a belly on him, like I have. You know, he's not exactly the most skinny guy. I mean, he's okay. He's just normal. Just like your average Joe. I mean, this is the thing. I mean, a lot of people think when it comes to creating the sim, they have got to sort of make the faces absolutely perfect and, like, you know, handsome or beautiful and whatever. Me, not so much. I just like to make people normal, in a sense, you know. I mean, it might seem boring, but it's different from everybody else that are doing, like, pretty outrageous things and whatever. So, let's click... Oh, hello. Biddleplot. Click the check to save this household to your library. Oh. Yeah, he's already been saved. I've just loaded him. Because I've done all the sim creation before I kind of started recording. I thought, no, I'm not going to take you through all the process that I've gone through. The choosing of the clothes and blah, blah, blah. So as you can see, here's the tip that comes up. Moving in. This is obviously because it's the first time that I have, that I am playing it. Obviously I haven't moved in yet, so, right. What we can do is find a place. Oh, that was a non-residential. That's a park. I think these... How much have I got? 20,000 simoleons. That's your usual thing. One thing I'm going to do is, I mean, some people have designed, like, they've built their own house and blah blah blah. I'm not going to do that. I'm going to just I'm going to do it the honest way, in a sense. That was what I was trying to think of in my Sims 2 video. The legacy play. That was the legacy challenge. That was it. Is what people used to do, mainly with the Sims 3. Oasis Springs. Oh, yeah. I know. Starter home. This is a great starter home. Blah, blah, blah. What's that? Nookstone. 13,064 simoleons. 20 times 15. One bed, one bath. Oh, okay. But the problem with this, it's all, like, desert. Don't think I really want to, not sure I want to live in the desert. Well, not right now, anyway. okay, then, so... Starter home. This is a great Willow Creek starter home. You can click this lot to move in. Right, so that's just got one bed and one bath. But it costs 15,965 simoleons. that costs a little bit more. That's got two bedrooms and one bath, but it costs less. Huh. Okay. So, I guess we'll just go for that one then. As it suggests, that one. Yeah, we want it furnished because we want some basic furniture in the house. And so, here we go. Right, here we are, taking control. There are so many new features in The Sims 4, before we can get to all of them, we need to cover the basics. Learn how to control your Sims. Okay. Scroll the mouse wheel in and out. Right, okay. Simple enough. Rotate, hold down the right mouse button. Ah, okay, that's different. It's usually the middle mouse button. Move the camera, hold down the left. Ah, okay, so. Right. For some reason, they've decided to mess up the controls a little bit because those are quite different to what I'm used to. Right. If you don't know the defaults, hit the keys Control Shift Tab to toggle to an alternate setting, which will be familiar to fans of The Sims 3. Okay. Wall controls. Modify whether the walls in the house are shown. Aha, okay. Walls up, walls down. That's what I usually have. Focus the camera. It's easy to focus the camera. You click that. Ta-da. Right, okay, yeah. Follow the camera. If you right click. Ah, so yeah, you normally follow them around. Time controls. You can pause, speed up, or slow the game, or let things proceed normally while using the time controls. Well, that's typical. I wonder if I press 1. Okay, there's normal speed. 2, 3, 1. And straight away, he has a piss. Nice one, Flabadah! Okay, and we press O. Or 0, I should say. And it pauses the game. Great, so at least the number keys work for the speeds of the game. Interaction jewels, implants. Oh yeah, notice they all seem to appear at the side this time. Interactions inside the box are the ones your sim is currently doing, blah 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 blah. Right, okay. Multitasking. Sims can now multitask. This means they are no longer restricted to a single interaction at once. Try conversing while exercising or watching television. Ah. Well, I kind of did in The Sims 2, where you would join them watching the TV and you would talk to them at the same time. So that's kind of not new. Sorry, EA, but that's kind of not new, really. Sims have minds of their own based on their emotions, traits and needs. They will make decisions that will surprise, delight and sometimes bewilder you. Alright, playing with emotions. A second that emotion. Sims can experience an entire range of emotions that will change their lives in big small ways. We're going to make your sim inspired to demonstrate how one of the emotions works. Okay. We're going to give your sim an inspired moodlet so they become inspired. This is an emotion that makes your sims better at being creative. Yeah, kind of. No. It's sort of a thing that's been done before. Inspiration, your sim is now inspired over the emotion, positive, blah, 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 blah. Right, okay. Whim, your sim has a whim based on the current emotion. Whims are the desires of your sims. Hover over the whim to learn about it. Right. He wants to travel to the museum. Or he wants to buy a chess table. Right. Your sim is inspired and wants to cook. Because they are inspired, they will cook better meals. Click the fridge and select cook to prepare a meal. That's it, right click is that right, okay. Click and cook, right. Garden salad, grilled cheese, white cake, chocolate cake, scrambled eggs. Oh, what is it? Everybody seems to like do scrambled eggs. Every sort of YouTube video I've seen so far, they just do scrambled eggs. There are other things to do. So in fact, I'm going to be different and make a grilled cheese. There you go. Just a single serving, thank you. So let's press 1, 2, 1, 2. Get things moving, basically. Right, so. Oh. Right. I don't think you're going to cook something by sitting there. Cook. Grilled cheese, please. You did actually take the money for it. Oh, hold on. Why is he watching the TV? I mean, I know that's like... that helps you to get the cooking skill, but... I kind of didn't want him to be watching the TV. He's supposed to be cooking. Click the fridge and select cook to prepare a meal. Cook? Yes. I mean, do I actually need to... What? Grilled cheese? With garden salad? Single serving? See, you've taken my $3. Come on.
Cook? God damn it!
Cook grilled cheese. Yeah, that's what I want to do. Can I? No, that's it. Get rid of that. Okay. Oh, I'll just gain $3 because I'll just cancel that action. So if I cancel that one as well, ah, it gives me more $3, but that's okay. Right, so... Oh, the middle button, or as in the wheel button, does that. Okay. And it's the right button that does that. Okay. You know, I understand now why. You see YouTubers and they seem to be like really really kind of struggling with the camera. I can understand why now. I think I may change it to the Sims 3 settings because I'm now like I know what I'm doing. Okay, your sim has gained the cooking skill. There are many other skills to master as well. Open this panel to learn about the skills. So that's that. Improving skills. You can learn about a skill and your sim's current skill level by...
Negative emotions. Your sim's emotions will influence every aspect of their lives.
Moodlets. Sims will get moodlets as a result of what is happening to them. Hover over Grungy to learn about it.
Grungy. From low hygiene. Definitely some dirt buildup occurring.
Okay. That's why he's having a shower. Shower. Click on the shower to eliminate your... Well, he's already doing that, so... really need to do that. Open needs panel. Yeah, that's the one. Really, you need open sort of most often, because obviously that's, you're going to know, need to know what your sim needs. I do think that's a bit silly, why they've like constantly sort of hidden it away compared to previous sims where yeah, where it's constantly on the screen, which, I say, madam, you look rather oddly dressed. So, can I, a sim that is fine isn't feeling particularly strongly in one way or the other. Okay. Okay, he's finally finished. So what now, Flabadah? Well, I'm not sure. And I keep getting... keep getting these buttons mixed up. No, that's not that one. That's that one. Right. As you can see, this house is a bit different as well from what I've seen on other YouTubers. They all seem to pick the same house. As you can see, this one's slightly different. Normally, the ones that you see others you see on YouTube, the kitchen's at the back there. Well, now the kitchen. Kind of there, the bedrooms at the back there, the living rooms kind of at the front there, and so there you go, we've got a different kind of house. So there it is.
This is my house.
How can I? Flabadah is a genius. Genius sims are more focused for mental pursuits. Okay. The thing I'm trying to do is bring the camera down. Camera angles. Or is that camera controls, or is that. Oh no, that's where you take a picture and stuff like that. No. Notification, build mode, no. Okay, so anyway, for now, I'll leave it there. That's like plenty to have started with, I think. I don't want to bore you with, you know, doing too much right now, because there isn't that much that I can do, really. I just need to sort of figure out things, get him started, and once I've done that, and once I've changed the camera controls, then hopefully I'll be able to get better into it and get things going. So for now, I thank you for watching. If you want to see more, please like and subscribe, and I will try and, you know, make this into a series, as well as my Sims 2. I'll continue with that still, but obviously I'll be playing some Sims 4 as well. So for now, thank you for watching, and goodbye!